copy, Mike. Do you copy?
Yes?
Could you bring one excavator to the wall cut, please? Could you bring one excavator to the wall cut, please?
Okay.
Thank you.
100 miles west, at Paradise Hill, King of the Klondike, Tony Beets, is struggling to hit his 4,500-ounce season goal. With no water license for the Indian River and a ground war raging in the Yukon, Tony's looking to branch out.
Right now in the Yukon, there's a lot of people looking for ground. So you have a real fight on your hands. So as for buying good ground right now,
and awesome,
you just want to forget it.
But
I never give up either.
So we're just moving on to plan B.
There is some ground that came up in Kino, so I want to do a little bit of prospecting.
To expand his kingdom, Tony's looking beyond the Klondike, with all roads leading to Rick Netter's landlord.
Troy has some ground for sale, and if you don't look at it, maybe later on you will be sorry. It's one of these things you should have, you could have. So we'll go meet him and see what we can do.
Ago.
So now that you've got my interest.
Rick was lured here by the promise of big gold.
Finding that in a sluice box like that will drive a guy nuts.
Now Tony wants a cut of the action.
They get some coarse gold here. It's all glacial stuff.
Yeah, they say it's going to chunky country down here.
150,000 years ago, a glacier formed at the top of Mount Hinton. When it reached the quartz vein containing the motherlode, it scraped the nuggets downhill, depositing the treasure in sporadic pockets. Troy is offering Tony 900 acres along the slope of Mount Hinton, just 5 miles northeast of Rick's claims.
Tony, good to see ya.
So what do we got?
We got about 89 claims, I think.
Well, that's pretty good. This the only drill hole you got in it?
Yeah, this is the only drill hole here. It's, uh-huh. It shows some gold at about 80 feet, so I'm hoping the benches will be a bit shallower.
Yeah, yeah. How far do we have to go down, you think?
20 feet or so.
Tony's plan is to prospect a shallow bench of land, 80 acres of virgin ground, that should deliver results at just 20 feet. First up, dig a series of test holes 100 yards apart.
I'm kind of new to this ground. I don't have a clue what to look for down here. Troy says as soon as it gets in the bigger boulders, there should be a bit of gold. And yes, you can feel it getting really rocky, really bony, we call that.
After 2 hours of digging,
I'll take one more scoop, and then I'll just have a peek in the hole, I guess.
Tony finishes his final test hole.
Boy, you got some big rocks in there, Troy.
Yeah, that's what I like to see, those guys. It's always better gold when we get into the bigger rock.
Yeah, yeah. Let's put a couple scoops of this in there.
Hopefully there's some gold in there.
There. Let's go wash it by the creek.
Sounds good to me.
Oh, you got a long tom?
Yeah, it's my homemade long tom miniature sluice box.
Oh, what a guy.
Long toms are portable, simple sluices.
How does this all work?
Consisting of narrow sloping troughs.
Put it on the bolts.
With a strainer at the end, feeding into riffles.
And we got a little hose there.
Yeah.
Perfect.
There we go.
Okay, let's fire the thing up.
All right.
You're happy with that, Troy?
Yeah.
Good. Let's do it. All right.
Sure glad you brought the long tongue. Makes it so much quicker. Just throw it through, bingo, you're done. There you go, perfect. Well, what do you think, Troy? Should we sample that one or what?
You're out, okay.
Yeah, I think so. Well, see what we got.
After sluicing all the buckets, everything now hangs on panning the concentrate.
Well, we're looking for not the amount of colors, but the size. There we go.
After several pans,
one more try.
It all boils down to this.
There you go. Hey, we finally now got all. Actually, look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Right on. Yeah, that is coarse gold.
That is nice stuff, isn't it? She's right there. See that?
It's not bad.
For a small pan like this, that is pretty darn good.
In gaining a tantalizing glimpse of the promise of Troy's land, Tony may well have found his plan B.
No, that's encouraging. You know what? Hey, that's really going to make a guy start to think that there is a serious possibility out there. You know what I mean?
Well, I hope you give her some thought.
Oh, I definitely will give her some thought. I, of course, talk to my bank, which is the wife, and the kids, of course, because I don't make them decisions myself. We do that as a family, and then we will let you know.
Sounds good to me.
So there is options out there.
Every time Tony goes away, things seem to run a little smoother.
Yeah, maybe they should go away more often.
At Paradise Hill, the family gathers for their favorite pastime, weighing out their gold.
There, is that better? Probably not.
Hello.
What's happening?
You're gonna bring us some goodies?
Couple.
More gold, a bit more gold, it looks like.
Oh.
So, how was Kino?
Yeah, it was a nice drive. Yeah, weather was the but we did some prospecting down there, and it's very, very rocky ground. But we got some decent colors, so if the gold is there, we'll deal with it. Before we make a decision, of course, we'd have to do more drilling to make sure. There was some nice chunky stuff in there, so it looked promising.
Mike, how did the plan do?
It did well. Didn't have any breakdowns this week.
Oh, that's okay. So that's good. A full week in there.
Okay, pour that. Let's see what we got. Okay.
Who's counting?
Not me.
I'll do it.
Ready?
Yeah, pour the thing. Let's go.
5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60.
To hit his 4,500-ounce season goal.
110, 120.
Tony needs over 400 ounces a week.
200, 210, 220, 230, 240, 250, 260, 270, 280. 90, 300, 330, 350, 360, 364.82.
Worth over $650,000. It tops their best gold weigh this season by almost 60 ounces.
Okay, that's the biggest ones we've had this year.
Yeah.
Thought it was a crown of gold.
There you go.
If the wall cut continues to deliver.
We are at 3,628, and we have a couple more weeks to go.
Tony's 4,500-ounce goal will be within striking distance.
So it is doable if we keep up these kind of gold weights.
We'll get close. Anyway, that did good, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
We should be excited about that.